sand, please. The adjectives that you bring forth to the altar. Large grace, Bishop Ames, by the will of God, we present the Elder Conglani Cornelius Patton to you for public consecration to the sacred office of jurisdictional bishop in the Church of God in Christ.
Church of God in Christ has expressed confidence in you, in your character, in your devotion to Christ and the Church, and in your ability to direct the affairs of the local general interest of the entire Church, and that she has signally honored you by selecting you to this high office. The Apostle Paul warns that a bishop must be then be blameless. Husband of one wife, vigilant, sober, of good behavior, given to hospitality, and apt to teach. Moreover, he must have a good report of them which are without him, lest he fall into reproach and the snare of the devil. The general board of the Church of God in Christ has assigned to you as bishop the following duties: to uphold, obey, and defend the Word of God, to obey and defend the Constitution of the Church of God in Christ,
yes, sir,
to function as the administrative head of the ecclesiastical jurisdiction to which you are assigned. You are to seek out and discover, in cooperation with your district superintendents and congregations, a suitable pastor for each congregation under your care. You ought to encourage ministerial improvements and leadership training by planning pastor study groups, in-service training, ministerial retreats, and supporting the Charles Harrison Mason system of Bible colleges. You ought to inspire the pastors to spiritual growth and personal improvements for more effective witnessing for Christ and his kingdom. Also, to encourage visitations among the pastors in the homes, in hospitals, and penal institutions. You are to stimulate by your life and example, as well as by your preaching, the outlook and vision of your people, and inspire them to holy living and more dedication,
yes,
to the total program of the Church. You are to submit yourself to your superiors in the Church with all prayerful humility and by your example, teaching those under your charge to do the same.
Amen.
And finally, you are to seek out communities in your jurisdiction into which a Christian witness might be effectively carried. The pattern in as much as the Holy Scriptures enjoin that no man be placed hastily in supervision of the affairs of God's holy Church, and in order that those here may know your mind and purpose concerning this sacred office, will you, in the fear of God, answer the questions we ask you in the name of Christ and his Church?
Yes, I will.
Will you endeavor to live soberly, righteously, and godly as a bishop in the Church, so that you may be an example to all others in Christian living?
I will, by the way.
Will you instruct those who come under your charge in the Word of God to the edification of the whole Church?
I will do so, the Lord.
Will you, Ellen Patton, give diligence to faithfully perform all the duties assigned to you as bishop of the Church of God in Christ as directed by your Spirit.
I will.
Will you ever seek in true humility to deal justly and kindly with your brethren in the ministry and with all others over which you have been, you shall be placed as bishop?
I will do so by the faith and the grace of God and the Holy Spirit in my spirit.
Congregation of the Dryads, back to the eternal face of congregation. Saints of Christ, do you under God accept this man in this office? And will you give him your cooperation, your support and prayers as they seek to carry out the responsibilities of this office?
We will do so.
Thank you. You may be seated. The Bishop, E.A. Brooks, Secretary of the General Board, lead us now in the prayer of consecration.
Brother Pat, will you please kneel? Everyone with bowed heads. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all of the earth. We bless thee, O God, for the leadership of thy servant and for his industrious hands of dexterity and mobility. We thank you for the skill which he has developed through training and experience. We acknowledge, dear God, that every good and perfect gift comes from your treasury in heaven. And we pray that he may use these gifts and energies and abilities to bless other people, not only in the church, but in the community and in the world. Lord, we realize that the joy and peace that comes from serving others,
yes,
is a byproduct of unselfishness. We pray, God, that you would give him evangelistic fervor and missionary zeal as he presses forward to share with all those about the wondrous works of our loving Savior. Continue to make him conscious of the great privilege and then of the responsibility of expanding the kingdom of God and telling of your matchless grace. Make him strong in standing for right and truth. Increase his strength that he won't falter when faced with the need for courageous leadership. Bless the fruit of his hand that he can accomplish. And those things that he accomplished may have an abiding value. And then, Lord, let thy Holy Spirit attend all that he does and bring every accomplishment to a lasting conclusion. That it may glorify thee,
Jesus,
through Jesus Christ our Lord. Thank God.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Christ historically never possessed a large wardrobe. He said he that would be greater than you should be servant of all. And all he owned was Caesar's robe that he wore. And there is the censure, the purple censure, which is the garment of humility. You will recall reading that when Jesus washed the feet of the disciples, he girded himself or cinched himself with a towel. And he did not designate others to do it, but he took the towel humbly and in humility and performed the feet washing himself. check is the garment of priesthood. Many persons are called to do special work of God, but there are only a select few who are called to the leadership and princeliness of the priesthood. This attire is to be worn in the official capacity of carrying out your mandate as bishop. The shmir is the garment of a prophet. The prophet not only foretells through his preaching, but he foretells. It is a special gift that you cannot learn from attending universities. It is a gift from Christ.
Together on our knees,
place upon your neck, pectoral cross. The cross is not jewelry, it is not to be worn as ornamentation. It is to be worn in the left pocket of your shirt. It is to be worn over your heart. When I go through security and catching planes, I refuse to take off my cross because it is not jewelry. It is a part of my calling and commitment. It is sacred. It is the pectoral cross. Finally, I place upon your finger the bishop's ring, a symbol of sonship. You recall in the New Testament when the prodigal returned, before he got in the house, his father gave instructions. I want to reclaim him as my son. Put a ring on his
blood.
Oh yeah.
I know it was.